Hello, grade 9 students. This is Mr. Muhammad with you. The lesson today is about refraction of light. Before starting with the lesson, keep in mind that light has three main properties: frequency, and frequency depends on the source of the light. So if you want to change frequency, you need to change the source of the light. Velocity. Velocity depends on the medium, on the chosen medium. And once I say medium, I mean solid, liquid, or gas. Wavelength. Wavelength is determined, or if you want to change the wavelength, simply you need to change the speed or the frequency according to this mathematical formula, lambda equal v divided by f. So lambda depends on the speed and on the frequency, where this lambda is the wavelength, v is the speed, and f is the frequency. Refraction of light. It's a very important phenomena in physics and in optics. Consider here we have incident light ray. Incident light ray is passing from one medium into another. So it's changing the medium. Once you have change in the medium, so the speed of light also will change. The speed of light in air is different than the speed of light in water. Simply, the light ray, it will not continue in a straight line. It will bend. This bending is called refraction. So refraction is the bending of light when it passes from one medium into another. And the reason is because changing in speed of light. Since there's a change in the speed of light between air and water in this case, so the incident ray will not continue in a straight path. Simply, it will refract. It will bend. Now, as we see here, we have this dotted line, which is the normal. The normal is an imaginary line that's perpendicular to the medium. Part of the ray, of course, not all of the incident ray will refract. Part of it will reflect. Part of the incident ray will reflect. So part of the incident ray, which is the majority of the incident ray, will refract, and part of it slightly will reflect. Simply, here we have this angle. This angle here is called angle of incidence, which is theta 1. So theta 1 stands for the angle of incidence, which is the angle between the incident ray and the normal. And this small angle here is called the angle of refraction, which is the angle between the refracted ray and the normal, which is the angle between the refracted ray and the normal. So far, so good. Index of refraction. Simply, as a definition, index of refraction, it shows us how fast does the light travels in a certain medium. So when light travels, for example, in air, we're gonna see now how fast does it travel in air, and when it travels in water, and when it travels, for example, let's say in glass. So once the light changes the medium, so the index of refraction describes to me how fast does the speed of this light will vary. Now, in order to find the index of refraction, we have a simple mathematical formula here. N equals C over V, where N stands for the index of refraction. C stands for the speed of light in vacuum, which is always constant, 3 times 10 to the power 8, which is 3 times 10 to the power 8 meters per second, and V here stands for the speed of light in a certain medium. This medium as we said, could be solid, liquid, or gas. Here we have also the index of refraction for air, for water, and for glass. As we see here, in air, the speed of light or n index of refraction in air equals to 1. And these are givens. The index of refraction in glass is 1.5, where index of refraction in water is 1.33. The speed of light in air, it's approximately the same as the speed of light in vacuum. Approximately, there is no difference between these two. Let me write here, this one, speed of light in a medium. So, this 1.5 means, it means that the speed of light travels by 1.5 times as fast in vacuum as in glass. 1.33 here, it means that the speed of light travels n by 1.33 times as fast in vacuum as in water. So, the speed of light in air, it's approximately 2.998 times 10 power 8, which is near or very close to 3 times 10 to the power 8. And you're not responsible to know these or to memorize these. The index of refraction that's related to air will be given, and the one that's related to glass also will be given, and the one that's related to water also will be given. Now, what will happen if light ray travels from a region with less index into a region of higher index? Keep in mind that the index of refraction in air is 1 and the index of refraction of water is 1.33. So as we see here, n, and I will name this one n1, and this is n2. So n1, which is the n index of refraction that's related to air, equals to 1, and n2, which is the index of refraction that's related to water, is 1.33. As we see here, this one is the angle of incidence, and this small angle here is the angle of refraction. Simply, any light ray, if it travels from a region with less index to a region which is a medium, another medium with higher index, so the refracted ray, so the ray will refract toward the normal. So it will move closer and closer to the normal. So always, once you have a light ray traveling, for example, from a region with lower index to a region with higher index, so the ray will refract toward the normal and do not refract upward in this form. Simply, it will refract toward the normal and it will move closer to the normal. Now, here we have a very important note. Any light ray, if it comes perpendicular to the surface, simply it will continue in a straight line. It will not deviate at all. It will not refract. Let's see here. Theta 1, of course, it will be equals to 0 and not 90. 0 degrees. There is no angle. Theta 1 is the angle between the incident ray and the normal. And here there is no angle between the incident ray and the normal. That's why angle of incidence theta 1 will be 0. So then don't get confused with this point. Theta 1 is not 90 degrees. Theta 1 is 0. Since theta 1 is the angle between the incident ray and the normal n. So here in this case, there is no refraction, since the incident ray is perpendicular to the surface. Now, the other case, what will happen now if the light ray travels from a medium with, let's say, n2 is here and let's take n1 is here. I take this one as a glass, which is 1.5, and here you have air and equals 1. Now the light n2, the light will travel from a region with higher index of refraction to a region the lower index of refraction. Simply, here we have three cases. Here we have three important cases. This is theta 1, angle of incidence. This is theta 2, angle of refraction. Now we're gonna see three important cases. First of all, we're gonna start with the first case. Here is the general one, and now we're gonna start with the first case. Case number one. Keep in mind this important given actually will be here, theta C. Theta C is a critical angle, and in physics, in critical angle means, or it's a limit. Once theta 1 exceeds this limit, it's gonna go a total internal refraction. Simply, till now it's a mysterious sentence. Now I will give you theta C. Theta C, it will be, let's say, 40 degrees. I said case number one, if theta 1 less than theta C, okay, I will consider that theta 1 now is 30 degrees. So theta 1 is less than theta C in this case. Now, once we increase or decrease theta 1, always, always, once you are moving from a region of higher index to a region of lower index of refraction, so the refracted ray will deviate away from the normal. It will move closer to the boundary. It will move closer to the edges. Sorry, to the boundary. So it's moving upward to the boundary or to the surface. Now, since theta 1 is less than theta C in this case, simply the refracted ray deviates away from the normal and it will move closer to the edges. So this is theta 1 here, angle of incidence. Here we have theta 2 as the angle of refraction. In the other two cases, I will increase a little bit theta 1. I will increase theta 1 and we're gonna see what will happen as a relation between theta 1 and theta C, which is the critical angle. Case number 2. Case number 2, now I will take theta 1 equals 40 degrees. Theta C, it's also 40 degrees. So theta 1 equals to theta C. In this case, theta 1, which is the angle of incidence, is equal to the critical angle. Again, critical angle, it will be given unless we asked you to find it. Later on, inshallah, you're going to take a formula in order to find or to know theta C. So in this case, theta 1 equals to theta C, which is this limit. Once theta 1 increases a little bit until it reaches this limit, until theta 1 equals to theta C, look what will happen. Now by increasing the incident ray, the refracted ray grazes on the surface. Simply, it will be on the surface exactly. It will form 90 degrees with the normal. So once theta 1 reaches this limit, which is theta C, which is the critical angle, now in this case theta 1 or the refracted ray grazes on the surface, will be on the surface exactly. Case number 3. If we kept increasing theta 1 more and more until we exceed this limit, now let's say theta 1 is 43 degrees and theta C is still 40 degrees. And this theta C, it will be given in this case. So, in the three cases, I mean. So theta 1 greater than theta C in this case. Simply, once a light ray comes from a region of higher index to a region of lower index, so the ray in this case and theta 1 is greater than theta C, as we see here, greater than the limit, as we said, simply the light ray will undergo a total internal reflection. So the reflected ray will go a total internal reflection. So there is no refraction in this case. There is no refraction. Here theta 1 is equal to this angle, equals to this angle. So now we went back to lesson 17.1, which is about the law of reflection, which is theta I, as we said, equal theta small r, law of reflection. Now, this theta 2, let me name it small r, and here, I only in this case, theta I equals to theta r, this is the law of reflection, only in this case. So once you have, once you reach the third case, when theta 1 is greater than theta c, when theta 1 exceeds the limits, as we said, when theta 1 exceeds this theta c, the limits, simply it will undergo, their incident ray gonna undergo a total internal reflection.